one idea, everything you've ever known, everything you've ever bought, everything you've ever dealt with, all started with just one idea. Steve Jobs started Apple in 1976 with just one idea. And now in 2020, they are the second most profitable company in the world with $59.5 billion. Steve Jobs had one idea. He said that he wanted a personal computer. Basically, Steve and I invented Apple because we wanted a personal computer. We couldn't afford the computers that were on the market, and they were impractical for us to use. We needed a Volkswagen. Everything you've ever seen, interacted with, or anything, all just started with, once again, one idea. I had one idea that I wanted to get into filmmaking, and I started making videos, and now it's all I think about. As soon as I upload one video, then I'm already working on the shots, or I'm coming up with ideas for the next video. It's a never-ending cycle. I'm always just trying to go, and I'm trying to make as much content as possible. I'm always watching videos, reading articles, doing research, just doing as much as I can, because I really don't know where this could take me. Maybe one day I end up making a movie like Inception. I know you all had one idea that you wanted to pursue, but for whatever reason you didn't. Maybe you didn't have confidence in yourself, maybe you were scared of judgment, or maybe your significant other talked you out of it. In that case, I hope you'd reconsider your relationship with that person, and I'm not saying to leave them, but if the person isn't going to help you pursue your dreams, or if they're not going to help you improve yourself, then don't live a life of quiet desperation. Imagine Steve Jobs said, "Yo, forget that. I'm not trying to make Apple or make computers or anything like that." Then he wouldn't be worth $7 billion before his unfortunate passing in 2011. You know, you probably wouldn't be watching this video on your iPhone, or you probably wouldn't be watching this video on your computer or your MacBook. You probably wouldn't be listening to this with your AirPods. No Apple products would exist because he had one idea, but he didn't execute on it. So at this point in the video, I hope you understand what I'm trying to say. What if you pursued that idea that you had? Where would you be right now? I'm not saying it's easy to build something of value or build something of importance. I'm not making this video to make you feel bad about an idea that you had and not actually running with it. I'm making it in hopes that you'll remember it and you'll actually try it and see where it takes you. In my How to Live a Good Life video, one of the points was to have a passion project. So consider your idea your passion project. It's still early in the year, it's still the middle of January, but you can think of it as your New Year's resolution. So go try to build it over the next 2 years, 5 years, or 10 years. You really don't know where it'll take you. The one guarantee is that if you give up on it, then it's not going to take you anywhere. But if you stay with it, if you nurture it, and you feed it, you really have no idea where it could take you. You know, Jordan Peterson says that we don't know the upper limits to human potential. You know, we really don't know what'll happen if we dedicate a good chunk of time to something that you like. You can literally make YouTube videos on anything. I make YouTube videos on, like, life tips, I guess you could call it that. There are people that make cooking videos. There are people that make makeup videos. There are people that make unboxing videos. There are people that make videos about everything. But you either have to be first or you have to be the best. If you're the first on the platform, then you get a lot of attention of people looking for said topic on that platform. Then after people start discovering that platform, you're gonna have to be the best, because then people are gonna start looking for content creators that are actually putting out quality videos. If you want an example, YouTube came out, I think it was in 2006, and look at the videos that got uploaded then. One of the earliest videos that I can remember, I think it was like the first or second video on YouTube, was a guy talking about elephants at the zoo or something like that. I'll actually link it down below or on the screen if I remember. But look at that video and then look at videos now. Now there are people making films and like documentaries and short films and putting them on YouTube. So you can see how far the effort and the progress has come on YouTube. So if you can be first, then you'll get attention to your topic, and then you can slowly kind of mold yourself and make progress, and then you'll be the best at whatever your niche is. I know it's easier said than done, but if you're passionate about something, just try it out. It literally starts with one idea. There's zero people on this earth, including myself, that can tell you what'll happen if you put 10 years into an idea. You have zero idea where it could take you. So what are you waiting for? go execute on your idea and see where it takes you. And as always, thanks for watching.